In order to add or subtract terms containing radicals, the radical factors must be exactly the same. So for our first example, we have 7 square root 5 minus 3 square root 5. These are like radicals because they both contain a factor of square root 5. But in general, to add or subtract radicals, we should first simplify each radical, then identify the like radicals, and then we can add or subtract the like radicals by adding or subtracting the coefficients. So again, for 7 square root 5 minus 3 square root 5, it's important that we first recognize the square root of 5 does not simplify because it does not contain any perfect square factors. And since 7 minus 3 is equal to 4, 7 square root 5 minus 3 square root 5 is equal to 4 square root 5. Another way to show this would be to factor out the common factor of square root 5. So if we factored out square root 5 and put it on the right here, notice how we'd be left with 7 minus 3 times square root 5, which would give us 4 square root 5. We normally don't show it this way, but we could. Next we have square root m plus 13 square root m. It's always helpful to have a coefficient. So this first radical would have a coefficient of 1. Next, the square root of m does not simplify because it does not contain any perfect square factors. Notice both terms do contain a factor of square root m. So the index is the same and the radicand is the same. So these are like radicals. And since 1 plus 13 is equal to 14, 1 square root m plus 13 square root m is equal to 14 square root m. And for our last example, notice how each term contains a factor of square root 10, and the square root of 10 does not simplify. So we have three like radicals. Again, because the indexes are all 2 and the radicands are all 10. And since 4 minus 19 is equal to negative 15, and negative 15 plus 7 is equal to negative 8, this simplifies to negative 8 square root 10. So notice how in all of these problems, when adding or subtracting like radicals, the radical part does not change. Okay, next we'll look at some examples where we have to simplify first before we add or subtract like radicals. I hope you found this helpful.